Hey there, welcome or welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Trixie and I'm back for more virtual Christmas game ideas. These games are for all ages. I really enjoyed creating this video, so I hope you enjoy it. If you haven't seen my other Christmas virtual games video, don't worry because I will link it down in the description box below together with my other Christmas videos. So yeah, let's jump right into the video. First game is called Santa's Spell and Search Game. In this game, the host will need to come up with maybe 2 to 3 simple Christmas words like reindeer, nativity, Santa Claus, or Christmas tree. Once the host mentions a word, the participant's task is to look for items around the house that start with each letter of the provided word. For example, the word is reindeer. As a participant, I will have to look for items for each letter of that word, so items that start with an R, an E, an I, an N, a D, an E, another E, and an R. For letter R, I can get a remote control. For E, I can get an egg. For I can get an ice pack, and so on. I will have to rush bringing everything back to where my camera is at, and yell, "Merry Christmas!" The first one back who has a complete set of items wins the game. Remind everyone not to take their phones, tablets, or laptops with them when they get the items. They will have to get the items and run all the way back to the camera. Second game is called Stocking Stuffer. For this game, the host will simply put random small items in a Christmas stocking. You can put candies, a pen, a cell phone, small toys, and more. The host will have the participants take a peek inside the stocking, and the goal of the game is for them to simply guess how many items are inside. You can use multiple numbers of stockings so they can guess multiple times as well. The person whose guess is the closest to the actual number of items in the stocking gets a prize. If you want to level up on this game a bit, you can also play the third game instead. The third game is What's in the Stocking? Instead of guessing the number of items in the stocking, in this game, participants will actually guess what's in it. As the host, you can prepare random stuff to put inside the stocking. The participants will ask yes or no questions so they can get clues from the host. They will keep on taking turns and asking until they finally guess what's inside. The person who guesses correctly will be the winner. Fourth game is called Our Christmas Story. In this activity, the whole group will be composing your very own big Christmas story using 3 random items from the house. The host will keep the instructions a secret in the beginning of the game and will ask each participant to simply grab 3 random items. Each person will show their 3 items to the camera so everyone can see. Participants will not be allowed to change any of their items. The host will then explain the game instructions and assign the participants on who goes first, second, and so on. Participants will take turns in using 1 item at a time to create storylines for a Christmas story. For example, my first item is a wine glass. I will start the game by saying, "I bought wine glasses to use for the Christmas party that we're planning with the whole family." The next participant will pick up any of his or her 3 items and continue the story. Let's say the next person holds up a scarf. He or she can say something like, "The Christmas party will be at Melissa's and she said it'll be cold, so I have to make sure I bring a scarf with me." After that, we move to the next participants and so on. All participants will take turns in contributing to the story using the 3 items that they have 1 by 1. The game should have a continuous flow, so if a participant pauses or if someone is having a hard time connecting his item to the story, then he or she will be out. Last person remaining wins. Don't forget to record your Zoom video call for this so you can listen to the whole story afterwards. Next game is Christmas Shopping. For this game, all participants will need any Christmas gift bag. You as the host will prepare a list of items that can be found in the house. Make sure the items are from different parts of the house, some from the bathroom, some from the kitchen, some from the bedroom, etc. so they really have to go around their whole place. Make the items very common, like a pair of sunglasses, a tube of toothpaste, and the like, so that everyone will have them for sure. Once everyone is ready with their bags, you will post the list in the chat for everyone to see. Another option is to hold up the paper that contains your list up in front of your camera, or you can text it to all of them as well. I find it easiest to just post it on the chat. They can take their phone with them if that's what they are using for the video call. They can also take a photo of the list so they can bring it around with them, or they can simply keep checking back on the computer. The goal is for them to run around the house to look for all the items in the list and put them in their gift bags. First one to come back with a full and complete gift bag wins. Game number 6 is Silent Christmas Carol. It's time to sing Christmas carols, but don't worry, no one needs to be a professional singer for this game. In this game, players will simply take turns in singing Christmas songs, but will do this while their microphones are muted. The rest of the participants will have to guess the Christmas carol being sung. The person who guesses correctly gets a point, and whoever gets the most points wins. The next one is also a good get-to-know-you game, and the game is called My Gift from Santa. Before getting on the video call, the host will have to ask the participants to secretly message him or her the answers to the following. First, what are your 5 most favorite dishes? Second, what are 5 dishes that you dislike? Third, what are 5 things or hobbies that you enjoy doing on your free time? As the host, you will use the answers to create a guessing game about each of the participants. Once the game starts, you will start each question with Santa is getting this person, or Santa is not getting this person, A, and then mention something that one of the participants like or dislike. The participants will have to guess who the person is. For example, the host will say, Santa is getting this person a plate of seafood pasta. Who do you think asked for this gift? And then participants will start guessing. The person who has the most correct guesses gets a prize. Last game is called Santa's Workshop. In this game, everyone will be elves helping Santa look for gifts from the workshop, also known as each person's house. The host will ask players to get 3 items from different categories, and players must grab these items quickly and show them to the host. The host can say something like, Santa needs 3 items that are round or have the shape of a circle on it. The participants will have to quickly look for any 3 items that are round and run back to the camera. The first one back gets a point. Other categories can be anything green, anything that can be worn by girls, anything that is used for the feet, that can be shoes, socks, slippers, etc. Anything you can eat for dessert, and so on. The person who gets the most points wins. Aren't those fun? Please don't forget to let me know in the comment section below which you think you will play. Also, if you have other ideas, feel free to put them down there. If you enjoyed this video, you know the drill. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell. Together, let's make happiness happen every day and live the lives we love. Enjoy your virtual Christmas games. Bye!